This is the 103rd story of the Sears Tower in Chicago on Tuesday, September 21st, 1999.
The buildings are all staggered, so they don't interfere with each other's view. The blue and silver building in line with the presidential towers is the Northwestern Atrium Center. This building, which resembles a railway streamliner, houses a
Buckingham Fountain. The best shot I can get of it at this angle. Lake Michigan. Just after sunset. The Navy Pier jutting out into the water, sort of like a South Street Seaport. The last rays of the sunset. The sky is such a beautiful color, I wanted to see if I could possibly get it.
By the Shedd Aquarium. In one of Chicago's beautiful parks,
Grand
Park, and this is a boat basin on the lake.
Field Museum to the right, Adler Planetarium to your left,
and the Shedd Aquarium in back of us. Flowers.
We keep getting parking places wherever we want to go. It's really worked out quite wonderful.
What kind of plant that is, but
it's some kind of
cattails.
Grass. It's called some kind of grass.
Cattails of something. This is a statue of General Kosciuszko. Just as we have a Kosciuszko Bridge in Brooklyn Queens Expressway. And it's obvious that there's 1 million Polish people living in Chicago. And they wanted their statue, and they got it. The Shedd Aquarium, we're going in there a little while, and here's a panoramic view of Lake Michigan, looking very green and blue today. Well, it is a freshwater body of land. This is Sammy Sosa's building. He lives in there. He has 2/3 of a floor, as they say. Baseball's been good to me. Can't resist shooting these beautiful flowers.
It's a sunflower.
And a beautiful sunflower. In the Sears Tower, we were up there last night.
The sunset.
And just a great shot on a very clear day of the Chicago skyline.
Chicago is known as for its architecture. All its buildings were designed by Sullivan and Mies van der Rohe and I.M. Pei and This is the polka dot ray. Living anemones. Okay. And some pretty tropical colored fish. Although they say this is cold water. This is a Cabazon sculpin.
That must have been a shark.
Sea apple anemone, Latin name cucumeridae. Giant green anemone, looking more like a flower. Yes, dear? We're at the dolphin show in the Oceanarium. And this is a very lovely spot. The show hasn't begun, but you can see the dolphins every once in a while come up. Lake Michigan in the background. Okay.
Thank you. they don't have hands like we do to scratch that itch. What better way to scratch an itch than by doing a breach? Watch off to your left. Breaching can also be very useful behavior in dislodging any external parasites that they may have on their skin. Well, now what's spine hopping? Well, that's when the animals position their eyes above the surface of the water. And what better way to get a better look at the environment that exists above the surface of the water than by spine hopping? These are also very curious dog bear flat on their back. Now this is called counter shading, and it can be a type of camouflage to protect them in the open ocean. Well, we certainly learn a lot about these animals, but if we just use our resources wisely, we can hope for a healthy environment for these animals to live in, to play in, and to survive in for many years to come. You know, sometimes the best inspiration for caring about the environment comes from seeing the animals in action. Now, we've shared a lot of information with you today about our animals, so right now, I'd really like to turn off our microphone, allow you to sit back, relax, and enjoy the beauty and grace of our Pacific white-sided dolphins.
Magellanic penguins, and some are rockhopper penguins. And, they can be up to 15 pounds each.
Where are they from?
Well, on the Antarctic Peninsula.
Are they going to a formal affair?
I don't know.
Yeah.
A seahorse. It's very, very tiny. In real life, I would say it's about 2.5 to 3 inches long. This is another variety of seahorse. I bet you never saw anything like that.
The pair remained strictly faithful to each other. She would ignore other moments as she passed through the room, and he'd take no notice of her feelings that had been situated. Seahorse mating would begin to the same age for death.
These are seahorse babies that the male pot-bellied seahorse gave birth to. The males are very large by comparison. The babies are very small. That's the male with his big belly, but it's a little hard to see.
The young burst forth, shooting out a few at a time.
Dragon disguise.
She did this.
There's a very colorful yellow one. These are all, oh wow, different types of seahorses. Who knew?
We think this was part of the Columbian Exposition of 1893. Of course, Greek columns. It's a massive, massive building. Oh, it's the Field Museum. I'm just gonna go in and spend an hour or two here.
Well, not that we don't have our own amazing dinosaurs at the Museum of Natural History, but when in Rome, visit the Romans. So this is the Field Museum dinosaur. What did you say, Marty? Possibly Sue?
No, this is not Sue.
Oh, this is not Sue.
I don't think so.
Not my namesake. But there is one named Sue.
This is the underground exhibit. And allegedly, we're shrinking to 1/100th size of what we are. Some kind of big grub. Signifying much to do about nothing, but interesting to look at.
This is Buckingham Fountain in Grant Park. Supposedly very beautiful at night, all lit up with colors. Buckingham Fountain.
Buckingham Fountain. In Grand Park.
Yes. With the beautiful skyline of Chicago behind it.
And you see that Chicago makes a lot of effort to take care of its infrastructure. About 50 cents.
I don't know who Clarence Buckingham was, but the fountain is named for him. It's his memorial fountain, A.D. 1927. Not a bad memorial, I'll take it. Marty was commenting on the kiosks that are very attractive, very French. Did I mention that Chicago is the sister city to Paris? So a lot of the architecture or the public places are very French in feeling. This bridge over the Chicago River is an example of the French feeling that I was mentioning before. What am I looking at?
I don't know.
A statue in Grant Park surrounded by pink roses. Guys were just fed by the Lone Ranger on a bicycle. They were real cute. Who are you? Okay. Here's a beautiful rose garden.
This is the Moore Dougal House. It was originally designed around 1903 and then it burned down a little bit and he redesigned it in 1923.
This is the Hertley House, built in 1902. By right to all of his principles of a house being an organic whole with its surroundings and its interior.
It's not a Frank Lloyd Wright house, but it's a house on Elizabeth Court, which my wife tells me.
It's forced perspective because the street is very short and it just curves a little bit off to the right and it forces your perspective, your perception, to think that it's a longer street.
And the street is just beautiful
and
charming.
It's in Oak Park suburb, which Franklin...
We're at Unity Temple now. Typical Wrightian doors. And the light fixture, designed by Wright. If this was the evening, we could see the wall lit up. Not Frank Lloyd Wright houses, but there's a very nice gingerbread Victorian. It's been repainted, very well taken care of. And this other house is being stripped of its paint and resurfaced. And the workmen are right there right now as we speak. It's 3-in-1. Tired mom.
Had to have a Busman's Holiday Shop. This is the Adams Wabash stop on the elevated. And we took a nice long train ride. Chicago Institute of Art, where we spent the better part of 4 hours on Friday, September 24th. This is what a northern Del Webb looks like. And since we're in the land of Frank Lloyd Wright, this is the sales office and to-be clubhouse. It's in the prairie style, which is apropos.
A little bridge here, going over a little lake.
Also very Wrightian.
That'll be a waterfall eventually. And another waterfall coming from the lake. Another water treatment. Now you can play the piano.
But I can't. Listen to how beautiful.
Very beautiful. This is an outside porch on this house. But what is more magnificent is what is just beneath the porch. I kid you not. This is a nice setting. But you know, when you're in Chicago, middle of winter, you're not going to use this. It's about 50 feet long. Has a nice lake view, and of course, the golf course view. This house is like 277 or something, but with all the upgrades, probably 377. That's too much. Stripped to the bone, this whole house is $289. But since it has a home movie theater inside and a basement, I would say $450 is more like it. And this is what I want to build in my retirement house. Nice little pool with falling water. Think about this kitchen.
This is a very, very nice kitchen. I really like this. The house has pluses and minuses, but this kitchen is really nice. It's got tons and tons of room. It's beautiful. It's got a bar, large counter space.
The opposite end of the kitchen.
Kitchen great room.
Kitchen great room.
Fireplace.
I should have put on backlit because I know this is going to be a problem.
Different. It's not the kind of waterfall over rocks that we're used to, which is very formal. Very pretty. See how the trees are changing color? I hear 1 week ago, everything was green. In 1 week, fall has fallen.
Just a little sampling of the outdoor gardening.
This would be,
yeah, this would be a street though, with cars on it when they finally build it. Well, it's Tuesday, October 25th, and we're at the Royal Mayan Resort. Another timeshare vacation. And of course, we have our pools. and sun decks. And that's the Caribbean over there, and there's a beach, beautiful beach that we spent the whole day on. And the water, of course, is very, very, very blue. Oh, I'm going down for our free drinks now. Let you know what's happening.
4 o'clock, getting a happy hour.
Calling all alcoholics. Is there a bar here?